this episode of Beekeeping Academy, I'm going to show you how to hive a nuc. What does that mean? Well, this is a nuc. Beekeepers use the word nuc two different ways. It describes a small colony, but it can also describe the small hive to accommodate the small colony. So nucs live in nucs. So this is a small colony. It has grown to the point that it needs more space. And rather than add more supers, I'm going to take this nuc and hive it. Hive it simply means move it into a larger hive. This is a 10-frame Langstroth hive. Some beekeepers will call this up boxing because you're moving up the size of the box, but I much prefer to use the word hive. So I'm going to hive this nuc. Really simple process. All I have to do is get the bees and frames from this nuc into this hive. The nuc, before we started filming, was sitting right here. So I moved it over and put a full-size hive in its place, and you can see the bees are already orienting at the entrance to this new hive. So the next step that I would have to take to get this nuc into this hive is, remember, this is a 10-frame box. This is a 5-frame nuc. So I've got to have frames in this 10-frame box because 5 plus nothing is 5. So I want to have 10 frames, so what I've already done is gotten this box ready with 5 frames. Now, you can use 5 frames of foundation, like what we have here. You can use 5 frames of comb that's being pulled or pulled comb. The better option is almost always to give them pulled comb because that means the bees have a leg up. They don't have to produce that wax. And if you want to, you can even reinforce this nuc by moving it over here with frames of bees and brood that you give from other hives. Now, I'm just going to say, for the sake of argument, we're moving only this nuc's frames of bees and brood into here, which means I have had to provide for it 5 frames. It happens to be 4 frames of foundation and 1 frame that's partially filled. At this point, it's easy. All I do is step to the side of the full-size hive. I smoke the nuc to get them ready to move over. Open the nuc. Now it's just the process of transferring these frames. Remember, this nuc is going to have a standard nest structure that most colonies will have, meaning there'll be frames of honey and pollen typically on the outside and frames of brood in the middle. So I am going to put those frames of honey and pollen on the outside of the open space in this hive body. Some people like to rotate in one frame, so put 4 frames from the nuc and the 5th frame here. But I like to start the first couple of weeks with all the frames from the nuc together as they grow to expand and fill this box. I typically do not look for the queen in this process, but occasionally people want to confirm that they've moved the queen over, so they will check for the queen while they are moving these frames from the nuc into the full-size hive. So I carefully pick up the frame, and if I were interested in looking for the queen, I can check. If I'm not interested in looking for the queen, I put it straight in here. Remember, this is a brood frame. I usually take out my 2nd frame, which means I'm going to take out the 1st frame next. It should be mostly my resource frame. Sure enough, it is. It's honey and pollen. So I'll put it here. Now I will slide the brood frame adjacent to it. And at this point, it's just moving 1 frame over at a time. And again, this being the 5th frame, this is the resource frame, it's going to go into this spot here. And now the only problem that I'm left with at this point is that even though I was able to move over frames of bees and brood from this nuc, the nuc box itself still has a lot of bees in it. So I am going to shake and bump it straight into this new full-size hive. So I turned the box so that you could see it with the camera. It's full of bees and brood. I smoked the bees mostly down in here so that there'd be hardly any that would be at risk of crushing. And then I bounce them like that, and all the bees are going from this box into the full-size hive. Now, when would I do this? Well, I would do it if my colony is expanding in the nuc and they need more space. I would also do it if I wanted to start new hives but didn't want to purchase packages or collect swarms. You can purchase nucs. Then you can hive them, you can put them in these larger boxes, and you can start your full-size production colonies that way. What would I do at this point? Well, it really depends on the resources available in the environment. Remember, I started this particular colony with a few frames of foundation. If I hived this nuc going into or during the nectar flow, I would allow the bees to use that incoming nectar to pull out those frames of foundation. If, on the other hand, I hived this nuc outside of the nectar flow, I would actually have to feed it once I get it into this hive, because there would be no incoming resources available to the bees to build those frames of foundation. So here I have a glass feeder jar that goes on the lid of the hive, and now I've hived my nuc. They will use the sugar water resources to start building those combs. I may have to continue to feed them until those combs are fully pulled, but now this nuc has space to grow and expand and become a full-size production colony.